4.3. Repairs are complete and the Enterprise is warping to rendezvous with Starfleet at Wolf 359. Communications from the site of battle have been cut off, possibly due to Borg interference.
Lieutenant Worf, everyone in this room shares my respect for your service to this ship. But right now, I need your experience at tactical. Commander Data, I realize your very nature omits ambition. Nevertheless, I want you to know I seriously considered you as first officer.
Thank you, sir.
But this is not the time for change. I need all of you where you are, where Captain Picard always relied on you. I have been, reluctantly, forced to conclude that Commander Shelby, our expert on the Borg, is an ideal choice at this time for first officer. Based on our latest communication, we can assume that the Borg survived the fleet's attack. Your thoughts on our next encounter?
What about the heavy graviton beam we were talking about?
I've gone over it four times. The local field distortion just wouldn't be strong enough to incapacitate them.
Dr. Crusher and I have been working on an interesting premise.
With our recent experience in nanotechnology, we might be able to introduce a destructive breed of nanites into the Borg. Nanites?
Robots, small enough to enter living cells.
How long would it take to execute that?
That's the problem, 2 to 3 weeks.
In 2 or 3 weeks, nanites may be all that's left of the Federation.
We have the new phaser adapters.
Maybe in concert with the photon torpedoes, we can slow them down.
I'm sure Captain Picard would have something meaningful and inspirational to say right now. To tell you the truth, I wish he was here because I'd like to hear it too. I know how difficult this transition has been for all of you. I can take over for him, but I could never replace Captain Picard, nor would I ever try. Whatever the outcome, I'm sure our efforts in the coming battle will justify his faith in all of us. Dismissed.